Yes, Tom Hanks. He's the guy that brings Fred Rogers to life in A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, the biopic about Fred Rogers. Now, it's less about Fred Rogers, got to be honest with you, than it is about Tom Junot. And you're going, who's Tom Junot? Well, several decades ago, about almost 20 years ago, he wrote an article about Fred Rogers. He was assigned to interview him, and the guy, Tom, was bitter in life, and Fred Rogers changed his life forever. How did that happen? Yeah, you'd have to watch the movie to find out. Matthew Rhys brings Tom to life, and you'll see. Hey, you guys, can I borrow you for a second?
Yeah.
Who are you guys?
We're the Popsters
from Auburn University, a dance troupe. Watch what they can do, because I just heard them doing it over my shoulder.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Would you be mine? Would you be mine?
Give yourselves a big round of applause. I sat down with the cast to talk about it, including Tom. Take a look.
I have played real guys before, people who actually existed. And sometimes I've spent a lot of time with the actual guys I played. Jim Lovell, Sully Sullenberger, Charlie Wilson. And all the time you say, look, I'm going to say things you didn't do and say things you didn't say and do things you didn't do. But beyond that, I want to be as accurate as possible. The added burden of, if I can be so bold, is Mr. Rogers, because it was not just the expectations of the man himself, but the expectations of everybody else about Mr. Rogers.
You got to play Tom in this movie. Did you hang out with Tom to get inside that head?
I did. I was incredibly intrigued with the inside of that head and the journey he went on. He was this incredible, rock star journalist of the 90s in Esquire. And Fred Rogers sought him out when Esquire approached Fred to say, we'd like to do a big piece on you.
Sure.
Read all these pieces and went, I want Tom Junot to interview me because he saw something in him that he wanted to kind of, to broach and see what was going on in Tom's mind. And as a result, we have this movie.
From what I know from your writing and, of course, the way it's depicted in the movie, that your heart is enormous. You had to weep when you saw Tom Hanks transform into Fred Rogers.
Yeah, the experience of watching the movie for the first time, I mean, I stumbled out of that movie theater and sat down on a park bench and, was weepy and exhausted and relieved and exhilarated, all of those things. It was an incredibly emotional experience. And I have to say that I've seen it, two times since. And, every single time it's hit me pretty hard.
What I love about your take on this is that you didn't put Tom Hanks through countless hours of prosthetic makeups to try to make him absolutely pull it off.
It was a philosophical point of view. What we needed was the essence of Fred. We needed his emotional heart to be right. We needed what was happening behind the eyes to be right. It wasn't about every gesture being perfect or it being a perfect impersonation, because if we were watching the work of that, it would separate us from him. It was about getting us as close to the real, to Fred as possible, a very intimate portrait.
I have always wanted to have a neighborhood just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you.
Most of this beautiful day. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day in the neighborhood.
Look, all these years later, Fred Rogers still bringing us together just like that. You guys, thank you very much.